Thank you, Dr. Chabot. So today I'm here to talk about growth. What is growth? We all want to grow this way usually, but not that way. But, we want personal growth, career growth, financial growth. But the fact is there's a lot of ways to measure growth. So when I first came here 5 years ago, the Pancreas Center was heavily surgicentric. Our laurels kind of rested on our operation case counts. That was the measure we told everyone to show that we were growing. And while I love each and every one of my surgeons very much, and they do outstanding cutting-edge work, I knew that my job as the administrative director was to broaden that measure of growth. So now I have the new patient volume for everyone in the Pancreas Center, including interventional, endoscopy, medical oncology. These show all of the silos that used to exist now incorporated into one metric of growth. Better, but not good enough for me. So I decided that while quantitative growth would always be important, the focus needed to be filling in the gaps. We needed to figure out how we could be a bigger, better, comprehensive center and address different needs like nutrition, family needs such as family housing, community events with PanCan and Less Garden, support groups, bringing in the best and the brightest in the research world here in a symposium we host, and finally, tackling that social media. Social media, the internet. So Dr. Chabot, I don't know, he wasn't really a big believer in Facebook and Twitter when I talk about it. He'd say, I think he finally got the Twitter thing though. So this will show you our new patient referrals and what used to be our traditional referral venue of direct physician referrals to the center, you can see has now changed. And that 17% of our new patients are coming from the internet or through a friend or relative who found us, and again, usually on the internet. So what this shows is how proactive patients are in their own healthcare, that they are now utilizing the information on the internet to make good decisions, informed decisions. They are the primary decision makers now. So what are we gonna have to do? Well, we did a lot of upgrading on pancreascenter.com. I have to thank the Office of External Affairs because I put pictures up there every single day. And you can see from 2011 to 2012 that the number of unique visitors to our website has increased, as well as the overall visits. And some of the things that we've done to make our website interesting, besides all the pictures I post, are some great blogs. Blogs about nutrition, blogs about prevention. We have Stories of Hope, where we feature a lot of our patients, where they can tell their story and thank their families. We have Pancreas Center updates, research updates. We did an awesome talk radio where I was very excited to debut my NPR voice. And here's Dr. Chabot's Facebook. One day I'm going to get him to tweet something. And finally, and most importantly to me really, is the team. I can't be prouder of all these people here, and some not pictured, that really work every single day to help our patients. It's very hard to navigate through the hospital system, and we can always do better, but I know that the team that we have here really, really cares for our patients and will not ever be content with just the status quo. So I know that in the future, there's gonna be a lot more growth, a lot more to come. So I'd like to take this time to also thank our friends at Lustgarten, the Pancreatic Cancer Action Network. They will be in the auditorium in the back with some information for you to take. New York Presbyterian, the oncology team, Tina is here. You can meet with her. Our nutrition services, Deb is here. Of course, the wonderful Office of External Affairs, the staff, who all, a lot of them showed up today to support us, our friends, and of course, our doctors. So thank you.